Yes, sir. So I was asking these people if they know any of the words to the song "Simple Man."
Mama told me when I was young, you sat beside me, my only son.
Here's one of the first line in "Simple Man." It says, "Mama told me." Listen closely to what I say. Mama said, listen closely to what I say. Question is, did you do what Mama said? But here's the next line from Simple Man. Here's the next line. This is what it says. You'll find a woman and you'll find love. It's true. You'll find a woman and you'll have a wife and a good marriage. That's a good lyric, and that's true. His mama's advice, that's true. If you go the way that your grandmama went. If you go that way to get a wife, that's right. You'll find one. You'll have a good marriage. The next advice in the song "Simple Man," Lynard Skynard, we'll say it that way. His mother said, "And don't forget, son, there's someone up above." Now, have you forgotten that, sir? That's Lynard Skynard's mother's advice, and Lynard Skynard's singing it to you. Don't forget that there's somebody up above. Have you forgotten that? Ma'am, did you remember that when you were trying to decide whether or not to come to this concert? Did you forget to consult God when the time came to make a decision on whether or not to come to this concert? Did you consult God? That's what Lynard Skynard's mother was advice to you. Don't forget that there's somebody above. Have you forgotten that? Do you pray about what does God want you to do with your life? No, you don't even pray about the most important thing of what God wants you to do in your life. You don't give it one prayer. Now, Lynard Skynard's mother is going to stand in judgment against you on that day when she's told you, don't forget there's somebody up above. And she said this, and be a simple kind of a man. That can be pretty good advice. And be a simple kind of a man if you mean this. David said in the book of Psalms, David said, Lord, my heart is not haughty, nor mine eyes lofty. Neither do I exercise myself in great matters, or in things too high for me. Behold, I am like a child weaned of his mother. Yea, my soul is even as a weaned child. What's he saying by that? He's saying, I'm not trying to be some smart person. I'm not trying to be some sophisticated, heady, high-minded person speaking in things I don't know anything about. Yeah, it's good to be simple in that matter, yes. And he says, my soul is even as a weaned child. What does he mean by that? A weaned child. A weaned child is a child. She's off of her mother's breast. He's been cut, weaned from that. And he realizes, that young child realizes, I've got to make it on my own. I can't count on somebody else to do everything for me. I can't pitch a temper tantrum every time I want something. I've got to behave myself. That's what David is saying. I behave myself even as a child that's weaned of his mother. So, if being simple kind of a man, if that's what you mean, that's good. That's good. But I'm afraid that Lynard Skynard doesn't really get the message that his mother's trying to say. I don't think he takes that message. I think he takes the message, be a simple kind of man. I think he takes it to mean this. If it feels good, that's simple. Do it. I think that's what he means. I think that's what he takes it, his mother's advice to mean. I think that's what he takes it to mean. But God has a comment for you. God has a comment for you on that particular way of thinking. He says, how long? He says, how long, you simple, will you love simplicity? And the scorners delight in their scorning. This is God talking to you. He's asking you, you say, I'm just a simple kind of a man. If it feels good, do it. God's got a question. This is God talking to you. He says, how long? How long, you simple, will you love simplicity? And the scorners delight in their scorning. And fools hate knowledge. Turn you at my reproof. Behold, I will pour out my spirit unto you, says the Lord. I will make known my words unto you, says the Lord. Because I have called and you refused, I have stretched out my hand and no man regarded, but you have set at naught all my counsel and would none of my reproof. You wouldn't listen to whatever I said. I also will laugh at your calamity. God's going to laugh at you when your calamity comes. When your fear comes as destruction. And your fear as a hurricane. And your destruction as a hurricane. When distress and anguish come upon you. Then shall they call upon me, says the Lord. They shall seek me early, but they shall not find me. For that they hated knowledge and did not choose the fear of the Lord. Are you choosing the fear of the Lord, sir? Good. The fear of the Lord is to depart from evil. The fear of the Lord is wisdom. That's what we need to do. We need to fear the Lord and depart from evil. It's good to fear the Lord. That's a good thing. It's wise. When I'm trying to make a decision, I don't know what to do. The Bible says, call on the Lord and He asks wisdom and He'll give it to you. So you know what I do? I say, Lord, help me to fear you. And a lot of times when I'll pray that prayer and say, Lord, I fear you. I think about how big God is and how little I am. That causes me to have the fear of the Lord. But I realize the difference in size between me and God. Now the problem is a lot of people, they get to the point that they forget the difference in size between them and God. They think, I'm just as big as God. They don't have the fear of the Lord any longer. That's dangerous, friends. That's dangerous when you lose the fear of the Lord. That's what happened here. And God's warning to these people, when He said, how long, ye simple? He ended up, He said, because they feared not the Lord. They didn't fear the Lord. They wouldn't heed any of His instructions. Therefore, shall they eat the fruit of their own ways and be filled with their own devices. I was thinking about that today. Because they didn't have the fear of the Lord, they wouldn't receive any of God's instructions. Do you receive God's instructions that He tries to teach you and teach you the way to go? Do you receive it? Do you cooperate with God? God says, because they would none of my instructions, they wouldn't hearken. God pleads with them and tries in every way to turn them from the path they're on. But they won't turn. They won't cooperate with God and do the saving of their soul. And so God says, therefore, they shall eat the fruit of their own ways and be filled with their own devices. And I was thinking this afternoon, what does that mean, God? That they're going to eat the fruit of their own ways. What does that mean? What does that mean, sir, when it says they're going to eat the fruit of their own ways? What does it mean, sir? I can tell you what it means. It means you having bad fruit on your tree. God says He's not going to suffer that tree to stand forever. He says you got bad fruit and your other people are the ones that's eating your fruit. But God says, from now on, you're the one that's going to eat it. You're going to eat your own bad fruit. There comes a time when you just repeatedly will not hear the voice of God. He tells you, don't do that. You don't care. You go ahead and do what you want to do. You do it anyway. God says, no, no, go this way. You say, I don't care, God. I don't care what you say. You can do that on and on. But God says this. He said to the man that's been over and over repeatedly, he's been warned, he shall suddenly be cut off, and that without remedy. We play around with God like that it's on and on forever. You know, that reminds me, this is a true story. This is a true story, happened to me. A lot of times people will come to my house thinking that I'm a Christian man and I'm going to help them. They'll come to my house, and not too long ago, a few months ago, a man was standing at my door. It was cold and rainy outside. He was standing at my door about 8:30 at night. It had been dark for 3 hours. He stands at my door, ringing the doorbell. I come to the door, and I barely do recognize him. A big man, long hair, long beard, dressed, hadn't had a bath in a good while. You could tell that by the smell. And he was basically wanting me to let him and his wife and his daughter stay in my house. And I didn't want to, because their life was way out of order. And I've learned that whenever somebody's life is out of order, and I get too close to them, some of their out of orderness in their life, it's going to get off on me, and it's going to cause me some trouble. I've learned that in life. And so I didn't want to let them stay in my home, but I did. And I told them one day, I said, God hasn't given me the permission to set a certain day when you're going to have to be out of my house. He hasn't given me that permission. But I feel like that He's going to, and I don't feel like it's going to be a real long time from now. I feel like God is going to give me permission to say, you've got to leave. And I know they were thinking, well, He'll change His mind before that day comes. They were thinking, I'll do that, because I'd done it before. But I knew I wasn't going to. Now, they had been living in my home, not just in the bedroom that they were living in, but they had access to all of my home and to the building that I owned and to the little outbuilding that had a lot of tools. They had use of any of my tools that they wanted to use. I let them bring their animals, their dogs and cats, and let them stay in my yard. And I had fellowship with them. And some of my friends would come over, and they would have fellowship. I tried to teach them and to show them the error of their ways and to get their life in order. But they none of that had any effect on them. They just kept going on the way. That's the same way we do with God. He's trying to instruct us, but we just say, oh no, I'm not going that way. I'm not going that way. And we think God will just keep on putting up with us. We think God will keep on putting up with us because He always has. And that's what they thought. They thought that I would just keep on putting up. I wouldn't let Him. But that day came. And I told them, yeah, you are. You're going to have to leave this day. And they did have to leave that day. They left all the benefits of being in my home. The fellowship of being. I liked them. I didn't hate them. They left all of that. They left the use of all my home. The air conditioning, the electricity, all those things. They couldn't afford any of those things. They left all the benefits of my home, and they were cast away, cut off. Now people think that God is going to continue to be putting up with them no matter what they do. God's going to keep putting up with me because He always has. He's always let me do. He never has cut me off. And that's what they were saying. They were saying, Steve's not going to really cut us off. But I did. And God one day, He is going to cut off. God's going to, we don't discriminate in America. We don't discriminate in America. But God's, you're going to see discrimination like you've never seen before. On the dreaded day of this world, God's going to discriminate. The Bible says He's coming back in flaming fire, taking vengeance on them that know not God and that obey not the gospel of peace, of the gospel of Jesus. He's coming back, and He's going to gather all the saved, born-again Christians. He's going to gather them together unto Himself. And then everybody that's left on the planet, God's going to discriminate against them. He's going to send fire and brimstone, flaming fire. And the Bible says that the elements are going to melt with fervent heat. And all of those people that say, God's okay with two men getting married. He's okay with that. He's okay with telling a little child, a little boy, if he wants to pretend like he's a little girl. That's okay. That's okay with us too. We're new thinkers. We're not that old-fashioned way like Grandma. Man, we're new thinkers. We're sophisticated. No, we're not none of them Southern people, them old Bible Belt people. We're sophisticated. We say it's okay for two men to get in bed and do abominations, working that which is unseemly, women with women doing that which is against nature. We think that's okay. We're going to teach the children it's okay. All them people, Christ comes, He's going to discriminate. We don't discriminate. God's going to. He's going to take the born-again Christians up off the planet, and everybody that's left on the earth, they're going to melt. The Bible says the elements are going to melt with fervent heat. Now, God doesn't want that for you. God doesn't want that for you. I can see the love of God for you. He doesn't want that for you. You know, glory to God. He'll receive us. He'll receive you if you'll just stop and turn to Him. Believe in Him. That's what He told that man. He asked that man, "Sir, will you be made whole?" Not do you want to, but will you be made whole? Well, here's a line in Simple Man. It says, don't lust after gold. Don't lust after gold. Simple man, don't lust after gold. All you need is in your soul. That's pretty good advice. That's pretty good. That's his mother's advice to him in Simple Man. Don't lust after the gold. Everything you need is in your soul. Well, the Bible goes along with that. It says the love of money is the root of all evil. And those that get entangled therewith, they're going to be pierced through with many sorrows. And what would it profit a man if he gains the whole world and loses his own soul? That goes right along with Lynard Skynard's mother's advice. You know, I think about Lynard Skynard. I don't know exactly. It was in the 60s, though. It's been some years. And I'm thinking, I see some people that's got some years on them that remember Lynard Skynard from the life, from the beginning. I see some folk that are in that category. And I'm just thinking about some of them as I see them. They got some age on them. And I'm thinking, they probably jumped on board with Freebird when it first came out. Freebird, yeah! I'm gonna be a Freebird! I'm gonna fly away! No strings attached!
person who didn't say me. I've been here since
Will you be saved? Will you be made whole? Will you be made whole, sir? That's the question. It's not can he do it. The question is for you. Will you be made whole? But that's what I'm thinking about those people that were original with the Lynard Skynard. They remembering from the early days and when they were thinking, yeah, free bird fly away, yeah. That's their thinking. And I just imagine it after a few years, they got a little bit of wisdom to them and they said, no, I'm not gonna do that. That's not a legitimate way of thinking, free bird, no attachment, no strings. No, that's not legitimate. I'm gonna trash that idea. I'm gonna be responsible for my life. And so now they go on for years and years trying to live an upright life, and now they get on down a little bit longer in life, and here they are, turning back to their vomit, going right back to that, not just a group like it, but the same Lynard Skynard, gonna go listen to Free Bird, I'm gonna fly away, yeah, no strings for me. Like a dog returning to his vomit, so a fool returns to his foolishness. What a shame. What a shame. Here's the last lyric of Simple Man. Here it is. Boy, now this is his mother giving him instructions. That's what the song is. It's his mother giving him instructions. And she says, boy, don't you worry. You'll find yourself. Follow your heart. And nothing else. Hey, that sounds pretty catchy, doesn't it? Follow your heart. But the Bible says, the heart is deceitful above all things and desperately wicked. Who can know it? No, that's not some good advice. Follow your heart above all else. That's not good. You need to fear God. Don't trust in your heart, but fear God and believe and do His commandments. That'd be the wise things. The Bible says to guard your heart, for out of it proceeds the issues of life. But instead of guarding your heart, you're going into a place, you're going to fill it up with dark things, some wicked things. And then you're going to take Lynard Skynard's mother's advice, and you're going to follow your heart. All those wicked, dark things in your heart, you're going to follow your heart, ma'am, sir. You're going to follow your heart. I wonder where you're going to end up. You think it's going to be heaven? I got my doubts. I think it's going to be, you're willing to follow your heart that's got darkness and wickedness. I think the place that's going to lead you to is a dark place. A place called outer darkness. Bad daddy alert.